Our next speaker is a professional basketball player. Here to give us an intricate insight from her experiences, please welcome Ms. Shannon Denise Bobbitt.
Merhaba. Nasılsın? That's the only Turkish I know. Good evening. Thank you for having me. My name is Shannon Bobbitt, and I'm from New York City. Living in New York City is not easy. You have to look at it from a different perspective. It could be bad or even good, depending on how you look at it. I grew up in New York City, and it was really rough for me. I am a family of 8 children. My parents did whatever they could to make sure we had shelter, food, and clothes on our back. And we continue to think positive and stay focused in life. And so we had a tragedy one night. My little sister passed away. And my parents was in disbelief, really down and out. They thought life was over. And so they decided they wanted to make a transition and move to a different environment. And so we moved down south. Once we moved down south, one day my parents wanted to go and play basketball with my family. And I asked, could I go? They said, no, Shannon, you can't go. You're too small. You're not going to be able to play. So I started crying. I cried. And my dad said, okay, Shannon, come on. Those tears went away instantly. We went to the park. They playing basketball, my family playing basketball. I'm standing on the sideline, very excited. And one possession, the basketball went off the court and came out of bounds. I grabbed that basketball, and I fell in love that moment. From that moment, I fell in love once I grabbed the basketball. I started dribbling the basketball. My family said, Shannon, we need the basketball. I'm like, no, I'm having fun. So I gave the basketball back. I continued to watch them play. And from that experience, I fell in love with basketball. We then moved back to New York City, where a lot of opportunity is in New York City. And since I fell in love with basketball, that's all I wanted to do every single day is practice and play basketball. I will go to school, do my homework in school, so I will be able to come home and continue to play basketball. And so we came back to New York, and every day I wanted to play basketball. When I came from school, and even in the mornings before I went to school, I would practice every single day. I started to practice with only guys. I never played with women, never played with girls at all. I even played football some days. I'm a family of 8. Like I said, I have 5 brothers and 2 sisters. And so I used to be out in the park playing basketball with all the guys. The guys like, she's a girl, she can't play. I'm like, guard up. You can't guard me. And, you know, just talking back and forth. That's what New York is about. A lot of trash talking, a lot of toughness. And so I continued to play until one day a coach seen me playing. And he recommended that I take my talents to a good school. And so he introduced me to a teacher who went to a Catholic school. I asked my parents, could I go to this school? And they couldn't afford it. We didn't have no money. And we had some great friends and family of my friends to help pay for my tuition. And I was able to go to that Catholic school and play. And that changed my whole life from there. I was playing in all the top tournaments in New York City. I was now becoming known of the girl who played basketball. Every day, everybody used to call me the WNBA player. And that's when I knew I wanted to make something of it. And I knew school came first. In order for me to play basketball, I had to make sure my schoolwork was right. And I did that. I worked as hard as I did on the court, off the court. School was a lot harder than basketball for me. I wasn't the brightest kid in school. I just worked really hard. And I got as much help as I could in order for me to play basketball. So I actually used school for me to be able to play basketball. As I grew older and went on to high school, we won championships. And I was playing at Madison Square Garden, one of the best arenas you can possibly play for in New York City. That's where all the great NBA players played at. And I was fortunate to have that opportunity to play in Madison Square Garden. We played well. We won championships. And I continued to work hard. And then in school, it was now time for me to take the SAT, the ACT, to get into a college. I prepped for the SAT every single day, and it was just difficult for me. I didn't qualify. I didn't get the score that I needed because my grades weren't so good. And so now I had to go to junior college. I couldn't go to the Division I school that I wanted to go to. And so I had to go to a JUCO. So right now I want to show you guys a little short workout video of what it took for me to get where I'm at right now. So take a look at this video.
Lonely like a highway, she's living in a world and it's on fire. Feeling like a catastrophe, but she knows she can find a way.
That's what it took, hard work, late nights, early mornings, by myself in a park, just me believing in myself, having confidence in myself. A lot of people told me I wasn't going to make it, I wasn't going to make it pro, but I continued to strive, even though I didn't get my score and I wasn't able to go to Division I. I went to junior college, which is a two-year college in Texas. I worked extremely hard, and I got my associate's degree. And then it was time for me to go to Division I. I wanted to go to Maryland University. I spoke to the coach, and the coach wanted me. She said, "Yeah, Shannon, we want you to come to our university." I was extremely honored. I was excited. I was ready to sign my letter of intent until she called me back and said she no longer wanted me. She was interested in another point guard because the other point guard was taller. And so I've been rejected a lot because of my height. But I didn't let that stop me. I kept my confidence and my belief, and I had a great support system around me who believed in me. So that helped me a lot to have a great people in my corner. And then it was time for me to still choose a school. University of Tennessee happens to have an opening at the point guard position. The point guard that Maryland wanted was the point guard that left the University of Tennessee. So that opened up the spot for me. And I signed that letter, and I went on to the University of Tennessee and played for Pat Summitt and won 2 championships back to back. That was the best moment of my life, playing on the biggest stage in the NCAA and winning 2 titles. Went on and we won. After that, now it's time to go pro. Everybody was wondering if I was going to get drafted into the WNBA. I had no idea. After the game was over, I was exhausted. I was tired. We was on our way back to the University of Tennessee to have our university parade. And once we landed, I had got several emails saying, "Shannon, you got drafted. You going to LA Sparks." I was extremely honored and excited. From that day, I knew hard work would pay off, and continue to believe in yourself and have confidence in yourself, and you're able to do anything in life that you want. And that's why I'm here, to inspire you guys to continue to work hard. Always have confidence in yourself no matter what. Believe in yourself. And I went on and got drafted. And now I played at LA Sparks. I played with the Indiana Fever. I played with Washington Mystics. And I also had the opportunity to come abroad and play in Turkey 4 years and play in it. And I also played in Israel and Poland. So I want to show you now what my hard work did. All my hard work, all late nights, early mornings, how it paid off in my actual games. So take a look at my video in the actual games. And that's what hard work does. It pays off in the long run, and I continue to strive for greatness. Despite all my obstacles I faced, all my rejections, I got cut from several teams. I didn't get my SAT score. I didn't go to the right college that I wanted to. I never let none of that get to me. I kept my mind mentally strong. I believed in myself. I had confidence in myself. I continue to strive for greatness, and I give back to my community every summer. Every summer I have my basketball clinic that I give back to the underprivileged kids, and to let them know them too can strive for greatness. No matter where you come from, just believe in yourself, continue to work hard. And I am writing a book on my life, and the book will be about all my struggles and how I came out of my struggles. So I want to thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for having me, and I wish you all nothing but success. Thank you.